Virchow's theorem of DTFT. The statement of this theorem is that if the sequence x of n has DTFT pair x of omega, then energy of this signal, then energy of this signal is given by E equal to 1 divided by 2 pi integration over the limits minus pi to plus pi mod of x of omega square d omega. See, already I told many times, Virchow's theorem is meant for finding the energy of the given sequence in frequency domain. Okay, in the frequency domain. This is the statement of Virchow's theorem. Let's go for proof. Okay, already we discussed in previous videos, we know that energy of the signal, the energy of the signal in a time domain is calculated by using the formula E equal to summation n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity, okay, mod of x of n whole square. Let us represent this one as equation number one. Now here mod of x of n whole square is also equal to what? This is nothing but what? We can write it as x of n multiplied by complex conjugate of x of n. Meaning is same. Mod of x of n whole square, this is equal to what? X of n multiplied by complex conjugate of x of n. Hence, this above energy equation becomes, we can write E equal to summation n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity. This is replaced by mod of x of n whole square. This is replaced by x of n into complex conjugate of x of n. Let us represent this as a equation number two. Okay, fine. Now, this is what this indicates, complex conjugate of x of n. So let us write, let us take, we can write the inverse DTFT of complex conjugate of x of n. Nothing but if you apply inverse DTFT for complex conjugate of x of n, then we are writing by using the definition of inverse DTFT. Complex conjugate of x of n equal to 1 divided by 2 pi integration over the limits minus pi to plus pi complex conjugate of x of omega, complex conjugate of x of omega e to the power minus j omega n d omega. Okay, now let us represent this as a equation number three. Substitute or put equation number three in equation two, then nothing but here x complex conjugate of x of n is there. This is replaced by equation three, then equation two becomes E equal to summation n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity as it is, then x of n is there, that is as it is I written this part, as it is I written, then complex conjugate of x of n is replaced by this equation number three, then it becomes 1 by 2 pi integration over the limits minus pi to plus pi complex conjugate of x of omega e to the power minus j omega n d omega. Fine. Now next step is changing the order of summations. Changing the order of summation, and we get, as well as changing the order of integration, because I will tell now E equal to 1 by 2 pi as it is minus pi to pi. Okay, this term I will write first, complex conjugate of x of omega, okay, then e to the power, so this term is there. Now summation n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity x of n e to the power minus j omega n d omega. Okay, fine. Now the question is here, we can observe here this part of the equation, this is nothing but by comparing with this part with the definition of DTFT, we can say that this is x of omega. So this is replaced by what? X of omega 1 by 2 pi as it is, my integration over the limits minus pi to plus pi, complex conjugate of x of omega. This part is replaced by what? X of omega d omega. See, mod of x of n whole square, this one we written, mod of x of n whole square, this one we written x of n multiplied by complex conjugate of x of n. Similarly, here we can see here, complex conjugate of x of omega multiplied by x of omega is there. This one we can replace it by mod of x of omega whole square. Hence, equal to 1 by 2 pi integration over limits minus pi to plus pi mod of x of omega whole square d omega. So this is what it is, the equation for finding the energy of the system in frequency domain. So this is equal to what? This is frequency domain. This is equal to, in time domain we can write E equal to summation n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity mod of x of n omega square. Sorry, mod of x of n square. This is for time domain. So likewise, we are going to calculate energy of the given sequence in time domain as well as in a frequency domain.